Yo, what is up, guys? It is your boy XPEC, and today I'm going to be showing you some Iron Banner stuff for the week. But since we're on the topic of PvP and Iron Banner and all that, my friend Shady made an insane, like one of the best Destiny montages I've seen. It's probably the best Destiny montage out at the moment. It has everything: sniping, a bunch of super kills, machine gun kill, like everything. It's mainly sniper, but it's an insane Destiny montage, and I really want you guys to go watch it. I'll put an annotation and link in the description. Go check it out. Tell them who sent you and all that. But this week, I noticed a lot of people were participating in the Iron Banner event, and I wanted to show you guys what I got. I managed to hit rank 5 finally. This is Sunday morning that I'm recording this. So what I wanted to show you guys is the God perks I got on my Jolter's Hammer. I decided not to buy much. Mainly I just wanted this event because of the Jolter's Hammer. It's that good. It's the legendary version of the Thunderlord. It's fucking insane. You'd have to use it to understand. So, from this event, all I bought was the Gold Spiral and Jolter's Hammer. Jolter's Hammer is, oh, I can't get over it. But a Gold Spiral's a really nice shader. I have it on at the moment. Stand in the sun a little bit. And my Titan looks badass with it on.
See how strong your might.
Here's what it looks like again. This is Gold Spiral. And it looks really nice with Helm of Saint. But here's my Jolter's Hammer. I got this in like maybe 3, 4, 5 rolls, which is like 10 Moda Lights, barely any Moda Lights, so this was not too hard to attain a weapon this good. So what I have is Soft Ballistics. It gives it a bit more stability, as you can see. It's kind of hard to see with the thing in the way, but it ups the stability, which is really important. And so does this perk, Rodeo. Rodeo kind of lowers the recoil, even though it's one of those like heavy machine guns that shoots really slow with a lot of recoil. It doesn't have that much, but a Rodeo does help a lot. And then Field Scout is a must with this weapon. And then I also have Feeding Frenzy, which this perk is ridiculous because it procs with one kill. Like, you get one kill reload and it doubles the reload speed. So this perk is ridiculous. And Field Scout is a must because without Field Scout, here, I'll show you. Without Field Scout, it only has 26 rounds. So Field Scout essentially doubles the ammo, and it gives you a lot more ammo in reserve. So you can't really argue not having Field Scout. Like, it's a must. So another thing I wanted to tell you guys is the nerdiest shit I'm doing right now is at this very moment, I am farming Glimmer so I can have 3 Jolter's Hammers of each type. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy another one and then use all my Moda Lights to try to get an Arc one, and then I'm going to use all my Moda Lights again to try and get a Void one when I buy a third one. So yeah, that's like 33,000, 34,000 Glimmer. So I got a lot of grinding to get to. Another thing I got was the Fellwinter's Lie. I actually got a Fellwinter's Lie to drop for me, and it only happened once. And so I would recommend, if you want the Fellwinter's Lie, you better get started. It doesn't start dropping till rank 3, I believe. But this is my Fellwinter's Lie. This is honestly like one of the most broken crucible weapons. I'm not a big fan of it, just in general. I don't really like using shotguns, but this weapon is so out of control. It's ridiculous. So has shot package, hammer forge, and field choke, which pretty much maxes out the range you could have on it. Some people may argue that range finder is better, and that's fine with me. But what makes this weapon broken is this perk right here, final round. So with Bungie kind of nerfing the shotguns, kind of lowering the ammo reserve, you can spawn in with like 2 rounds in your chamber, and this final round perk literally makes this thing a sniper rifle. I can snipe someone really far away. Like the other day, I was playing the base map. I can't remember the name of it, but fuck, man, I was like on B flag, and I sniped a guy across the room, like all the way across the room with this perk. So if you get this weapon, and you get final round and like shot package or range finder, keep it because this perk makes this gun unbelievable. And whenever I play against shitters, what I do is I empty out my mag so I have one left so I can keep proccing this perk, and it's ridiculous. It's honestly so broken. I've said ridiculous like 5 times, 10 times already today. But that's my Iron Banner stuff that I got. And another thing I wanted to show you guys before I go is I've been working on something pretty cool that you guys should be excited for. And right now I'm about at the halfway mark, but I will get to the 20 mark. So I'm trying to save up 20 faction packages. Right now I'm at 8, and I think I'm close to hitting the ninth one. Yeah, almost there. So we'll get there today. So I am 8 for 20, about to hit 9. So about halfway there, and I'm gonna keep grinding out, and I'm gonna make sure I hit 20, and that's gonna be a beast video. I'm gonna do all the openings in a video. So yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I really want you guys to leave a comment on what you got from this Iron Banner. I know a lot of people kind of participated in it, but if you haven't, it's not too late. You have Sunday, Monday to grind it out and see what you can get. So yeah, I will speak to you guys later. Go check out Shady's montage. I'll put a link annotation in the description. So yeah, catch you guys later. Peace.